Hey Sagittarius, what's up? It's Ashley from Serendipity Tarot. I hope you guys are doing amazing. This is your general love reading for the end of January 2021. We're gonna see what's going on for you guys in love. This is general, it won't resonate with every Sagittarius out there. Take what resonates, leave the rest. Check out your moon, your rising, and your Venus. If you want a personal love reading, check me out. The link is in the description box. You can also get a personal love reading on my Etsy shop. I also have some Oracle decks I'll be posting there if you guys are interested in buying and purchasing, and some other mystical goodies. So check it out. If this resonates, like, share, comment, and subscribe. Be sure to hit that notification bell so you know when I upload. I would appreciate it greatly. And also check out your extended reading for January 20th through the 31st. How does your partner feel? We're going to look at your person's energy, Sagittarius. See what's on their mind. How do they view you? What's in their feelings and emotions that they're not saying? What are they keeping quiet about? And kind of what's happening? How do they want to move forward? What's happening behind the scenes? What are the challenges, the blocks, and the outcome? All right, so check that out. The extended bonus reading will be, the link will be in the description box, okay? All right, let's see what's going on with my Sagittarius in love. Sagittarius in love. Cross watchers, you are welcomed. Hello, hello. Ooh, okay. Four of Wands with the Seven of Wands in reverse. So Sagittarius, someone has been resisting this connection that you guys have. The Four of Wands is telling me it could be a twin flame, okay? I feel like you definitely saw forward movement with this person. You saw that you guys were in harmony with each other. You felt like you were aligned. You knew that something here was very special. You guys came together and you knew it was for a higher purpose. But for some reason, this person was very defensive. Okay, they were not ready for something like this. This may have been too powerful for them, okay? And I think that they kind of blocked you out, or they kind of gave this they were running away from something here, okay? Maybe they were running away in fear of coming together here with you in some kind of union, okay? But I do see a person was very guarded. Now let's see what happened in the past. We have the Three of Swords and the Five of Cups. So your person definitely has caused you a lot of pain, okay, Sagittarius? They have hurt you very deeply, okay? You may be still healing from some kind of hurt or breakup or some kind of separation here. The Five of Cups is telling me that there's a lot of regrets, though, okay? Your person is having a lot of feelings of resentment for themselves or dealing the way they dealt with this connection. They could feel guilty for the way they treated you or the things that they said or the way that they went about it. Okay, there's something here that they wish they had done differently. And certainly, yeah, they could be feeling that Three of Swords as well. The pain or feeling the hurt that they caused you. Some of you guys, it was a third party that may have caused your person to resent or block this connection. Your energy, Sagittarius, is a Six of Pentacles in reverse. So you guys are tired of this person giving you less than what you deserve. Okay, because you've been putting your best foot front. You've been putting your best foot out there. You've been really investing your all into the connection. All right? You guys have really been giving to this person everything. And you've gotten nothing in return. So I do feel like you're dealing with someone who has breadcrumbed you, who's taken advantage of you in some way, Sagittarius, and you're tired of it. Point blank, you're tired of getting less than. All right? So there were some imbalances here. There was some unequal give and take and a lack of reciprocity that you got from this connection. Now, what's going on in the environment? What are you not seeing, Sagittarius? What's coming? What are you not seeing right now? The Two of Cups with the Queen of Cups and the Hierophant. Some of you guys are connecting with a Taurus. It could be a Cancer, a Pisces, a Scorpio. Some of you guys, the reason why they were not able to come towards you and have a partnership with you is because they were dealing with something here. They could have been dealing with the Queen of Cups, okay? There could have been a commitment here they were already involved in, or they had some commitment issues. This person was maybe afraid of committing to this connection. Maybe they were afraid of establishing it as a real partnership, okay, giving it labels or whatnot. But I do feel like there was some kind of commitment, whether they were dealing with some kind of commitment issues, a fear of commitment, or they were already in a prior commitment here where they couldn't come towards you, okay? That Queen of Cups could be the person that you're dealing with. They certainly had love for you. Okay, there was a lot of genuine love and feelings and emotions they had for you. But I feel like they weren't ready to take that next step. They weren't ready to have that Two of Cups with you. That's why the Two of Cups came out in reverse, okay? Now, let's see. What's coming into the moment, Sagittarius, for you and your person? We got the Ten of Wands. So there's a lot of burdens here. There's something that you're carrying still, Sagittarius, in this connection, or both of you guys are carrying, that is weighing heavily on you. Okay, it's also keeping you guys perhaps from being able to move forward. Perhaps you guys are not talking right now, but there's something here that you're feeling burdened by. Or there's some worries here. We got the Page of Swords and the Queen of Pentacles in reverse. So your person is keeping a watchful eye on you. If you guys are not communicating right now at this time, which is indicated by the Page of Swords in reverse, this person is watching your social media. They're still curious as to what's going on right now with you. Okay, this is someone who may ask other people about you, but not ask how you're doing directly. But they're very curious. They're very interested to know what's happening with you, Sagittarius. Now, the Queen of Pentacles in reverse could be a Taurus or Virgo, Capricorn. Again, there could have been a prior commitment that your person was involved in where they wasn't able to offer you a solid commitment. Okay, they weren't able to offer you some kind of relationship. I also feel like that Queen of Pentacles, this could be someone that expected a lot from you but gave you very little in return, all right? It could be an earth sign. They also view you as perhaps no longer pushing them for a commitment. Some of you guys have taken a step back. Okay, you're no longer focused on them anymore, and they may feel that energetically pull back. You're taking your power back, Sagittarius. What's in your energy? Yeah, the Hermit. You guys are doing a lot of thinking. You're very spiritual. You may be doing a lot of soul searching. You're finding yourself. Some of you guys, this breakup, this separation has really taught you a very powerful lesson about loving yourself, not giving too much. Okay, putting yourself and your needs first. And that's what you're doing now, because your person sees that you're not really interested in what's happening with them anymore. So the outcome is a Ten of Swords. Your person is feeling like there's an ending here. They feel devastated. They feel at a loss right now without you. This is someone who feels like their life has crumbled before them. Because Sagittarius, they passed you up. Right? They wasn't willing to give you equally. They may have been breadcrumbing and dealing with other people, other options. And they took this connection for granted. That Four of Wands, they knew it was something special, but they didn't act like it. They blocked you out. Right? They resisted you. They were defensive. And unfortunately now, Sagittarius, it looks like you've gone a different direction because you're pulling back. So let's see what the Four of Wands is about. Leo, Sag, Aries with the Seven of Wands. Yep, the Nine of Wands in reverse. Someone has given up. So this could be you, Sagittarius, so this could be your partner, but someone has given up a fight because this fight is no longer worth fighting. Someone's been fighting for the stability of the home, the family, coming together in a union to be able to have... to be able to make memories, to be able to come together for important holidays. And someone was just not for it. And so now someone is done. Someone is tired. Now the Three of Swords with the Five of Swords, got the Two of Swords in reverse. Someone has made a decision. And this decision has now caused, I feel like, your person to be in this Five of Cups energy. The regrets, the hurt, the remorse. Sagittarius, you may have given up on this person because you've been experiencing this Three of Swords pain for too long. And you guys are now releasing it. And that Two of Swords is telling me that you're no longer keeping yourself stuck. You made a decision to find peace of mind because you're in that hermit. You're focusing on yourself. You are very spiritually guided. Some of you guys are very intuitive, and you're really connected to the universe now and to the divine so that you can move forward and you can do what you need to do right now to reach your higher goal and your higher purpose in life. And your person is now having a lot of regrets, a lot of remorse about how they treated you. Now, on your mind, Sagittarius, you look at the situation as being very unequal and unbalanced because you gave too much and this person gave too little. And you have cut off communication, or you just stopped communicating with this person. Something stopped moving forward. You stopped reaching out. You guys are definitely a distance apart from each other now, emotionally and physically. So we got the Hierophant and the Queen of Cups with the Two of Cups in reverse. So your person is realizing that they were very, very, they were not giving to you in balance. There was a lack of reciprocity here. And it caused the downfall of this connection here, right? They also know that they weren't really giving you the same love that you gave them, right? When it came to emotional vulnerability and being available, yeah, this person wasn't giving their true self. There could have been another commitment here that was in the environment, or maybe they were already committed to someone else. Why is the Hierophant here? Or it wasn't time. Spirit is saying they weren't ready for a commitment. They could have just had a fear commitment. Something is telling me that something was not even in your hands anymore. Something here was not meant to be with this person, with this connection. There was something regarding a commitment that never worked out because it wasn't divine timing with the wheel in reverse. So it was a lot of struggles. There was a lot of blocks that caused burdens, Ten of Wands. May have left you feeling worried, Sagittarius, for the longest. But it was toxic. Something here may have been toxic. May have not been for your greatest good. The Devil could also have been a Capricorn you were dealing with. Or it could have been a way that you were looking at something. You were so closed-minded. Spirit is saying for you to open up your eyes. There's something here that wasn't for you at that moment. And it doesn't mean it'll never be for you. It just means in that moment in time, it wasn't yours. It wasn't yours to have. Now, the Queen of Pentacles in reverse could have been a Taurus, a Virgo, Capricorn that you're connecting with. You guys, I feel you've been loyal. You were the stable person. You had a lot to offer. And this person offered you very little in return. And there was an ending. Death card, Scorpion energy. There had to be an ending. There has to be an ending in order for a new beginning to begin. Okay? So if you guys are not talking right now, your person is watching you, keeping a watchful eye. They're very inquisitive, very interested, checking your social media, right? They have that eye on you, checking your pulse. Three of Swords, because now they're the ones who's experiencing some hurt, some heartbreak. Now they're the ones who are having to break ties with you because this is someone who's caused you that same hurt. Now they're experiencing this hurt much later. So that's what's going on here. Your pain, the pain that your person is feeling now, it's really their doing. And they can't get over it now. You're definitely on their mind. So Sagittarius, give me one more card here for your person. The Chariot, they may want to take some action toward you. This is someone who wants some kind of progression. It could be a Cancer in your life. This is someone who wants to achieve something here. They want to be victorious. This is someone after they heal, they want to come back. They're wanting to really bust down some doors here. But Sagittarius, you've been doing some thinking. You guys have been going within. You've been finding some answers. You're in that hermit energy. Virgo, some of you guys are connecting with a Virgo. This is your energy where you're just focusing on yourself. You're very spiritual now. You're healing. Yeah. You guys have really emotionally walked away from this person. Some of you guys, because it was a third party, or you just don't longer see the idea of coming back in a unity with this person. You don't see a reconciliation. Some of you guys, you struggle with this connection so much. It's left in you feeling emotionally drained and depleted, and you had to walk away from it emotionally with the Eight of Cups. You had to let it go. because it just got too emotionally heavy. Now, the Ten of Swords, again, this is an ending, betrayal. But what I'm seeing is that your person really, they would love to be able to manifest with you, but they don't feel powerful. They don't feel good enough. They feel weak. They feel like something here is out of their control now. Some of you guys are connecting with the Gemini. This is someone whose life is in shambles now. This is someone who feels incomplete without you. They feel like they've lost the prize, which is you, Sagittarius. They lost out on something that was very secure. They lost out something that was very promising, that had great potential. Okay, give me another card here for the Ace of Pentacles. Yup, look at that. They passed you up, and they passed this opportunity to have this Two of Cups with you. So this is someone who feels at a big, big loss, right? With the Ten of Swords, they're struggling with this loss, with this ending here, with this breakup, because now they see that they could have had this, and now they can't even manifest you back. They're trying. They're coming towards you with the Chariot. So I'm going to extend this reading over to Vimeo. Okay, this is for January 20th through the 31st. We're going to see, how does your partner feel? What's on their mind, their emotions and feelings? How do they see you? How do they want to move forward? And what's happening behind the scenes and the outcome? So check that out on Vimeo if you're interested. And if you want a personal love reading, check me out, okay? All right. I hope you guys found some guidance in this reading. And if it resonates, like, share, comment, and subscribe. All right, you guys, all take care. Stay safe and stay well.